fears of a wider war in West Asia is growing by the hour. Iran says it will not let Haniyeh's blood go to waste. Hezbollah and Hamas have vowed that the killing of Hamas's political leader has taken the war to a new dimension. On the other hand, Israel says it is ready for any eventuality. Will there be a direct Iran and Israel confrontation? Our next report decodes the situation and analyzes the militaries of the two nations.
Hamas leader Ismail Haniyeh's assassination has put West Asia on edge. Hamas says Haniyeh's killing would take the battle to new dimensions and have major repercussions. Iran's supreme leader Ayatollah Ali Khamenei has put the blame on Israel's doorstep and vowed revenge. Soon after the statement, a red flag was unfurled on the Jamkaran Mosque, symbolizing that blood has been spilt unjustly and it must be avenged. Israel has not accepted or denied the killing, saying that it is ready for any eventuality. So amid all the concerns over an all-out war between Iran and Israel, how do the two militaries compare? Iran has one of the strongest militaries in West Asia. It has 610,000 active soldiers, which far outnumber Israel's 170,000 troops. What Israel lacks in numbers, it more than makes up in its vast technological edge over Iran. Israel also has a massive defense budget compared to Iran. Israel also has the latest air fighting machines. It has American F-16s and F-35 stealth combat jets. Israeli jets have regularly shown their firepower in operations against militants in Lebanon, Syria, and Gaza. Iran has an upper hand with 2,000 tanks compared to Israel's 1,400 tanks. However, the numbers don't reveal the real picture. Israel has a state-of-the-art fleet of Merkava tanks, while the bulk of Iran's tanks are Soviet-era models bought in the 1990s. Again, in terms of armored vehicles, Iran has over 65,000 compared to Israel's 43,000. Again, Israel's military vehicles are much faster and sleeker compared to Iran's. Though at a technological disadvantage, Iran's military could have a significant stockpile of ballistic and cruise missiles and cheap unmanned aerial vehicles or drones, some it deployed against Israel on April 13th. But Israel can respond to the Iranian barrage with airstrikes of its own. Iranian air defenses are far less developed than Israel's multi-layered war machinery. Bureau Report, WION, World is One.
Following the assassination of Hamas leader Ismail Haniyeh in Iran, WION reached out to political and military analysts on what happens next in the West Asian region and the ongoing conflict between Israel and Hamas in Gaza. And these are some of the excerpts from some of them.
In Iran, we have councils, different type of councils. And these councils make the decision, like United States, for example, CFR, Council of Foreign Relations. In Iran also, we have many councils. And these councils have their own pressure. And the hierarchy of this pressure is too much for Mr. Pezeshkian. For that reason, I started that pity for Mr. Pezeshkian, because he started his cabinet and his career with the assassination and the lack of the information and something else. Anyway,
Haniyeh was by all accounts was personally taking part in lots of the negotiations to try to find a ceasefire. He'd been doing shuttle diplomacy between a number of locations, and to take him out when allegedly, at least according to some reports, the sides were getting close to being able to make some sort of an agreement, just bodes very ill for any possibility of reaching a ceasefire, much less an actual peace between the warring parties here, and raises the possibility of an expanded war.
The Iranians to fail to be able to protect an obvious target, a clearly very obvious target in Ismail Haniyeh in Tehran, is hugely embarrassing. And it's another signal to Tehran that if it was Israel, it shows Israel has the capabilities to penetrate Iranian intelligence.
There is the possibility of retaliation. At the same time, that's the reason why Israel is trying, has not publicly claimed responsibility, even though everybody assumes that it's Israel, giving the Iranian regime the opportunity to plead ignorance and not strike directly back against Israel.
it really speaks to the Mossad and the Israelis' ability to reach out and touch certain individuals when they want and where they want. Doha would probably have been where Haniyeh had been staying and sheltering up. Seemed probably like the softer target, but that's a clear message when you take them down in Tehran.
The psychological and political impact beyond just the concrete results of eliminating that individual is enormous. And that's why I think Iran will have to respond.
For all the latest news, download the WION app and subscribe to our YouTube channel.